One moment. Gotta find this. Oh. Oh, memento. All right. And me now. Right, perfect. So good. Just need another one real quick. This game is actually pretty fun. Except for the point where you have to wait a long ass time in the loading screen. Having abilities. Be chased by the killer for a total of 4 minutes with Jake Pack. I don't think I'll do that. I don't even know what he does. If I shit myself, I should definitely be fine, no matter what. If my phone wants to cooperate with me, grazie. You just kind of love, like, you know, the loading screen. That's one thing I don't like whatsoever. I think the bar's even gone up whatsoever, dude. Oh, finally.
Baby girl was head, showing your ass and body, so don't it get to cabin.
look at that little tiny bits and bits of it left that needs to finish loading. Oh. Finito. Don't worry, I got my diapers on. Greet. You motherfucker, dude. There's only two of us. Honestly, I thought that was a guy in the mic. You're a piece of shit, you know that? I am very, very sorry. Survive for a bit, please. I hear that sick son of a bitch. Fuck away from me. Don't see me. I hear you. Help me. You know you're a real piece of shit, right? You can do that too! Fuck you! You know how much I fucking hate you! You know, whatever. I'm done. I'm not even gonna fucking bother. Kill me now, please. Kill me! Pick me up! You fucking baked potato? Yes, fucking kill me, you fucking shit. You're an asshole. Hook me right now. Fucking do it. I hope you feel accomplished. It's not like if you did anything whatsoever. I'm not even. Fucking kill me, dude. I swear to God, I feel like this guy is gonna be thinking, oh, dude, I'm so good. No, bro. Two people decided to disconnect because it was so fucking laggy, dude. So no, you're not good, bro. Get on my face! Yeah, the little damn boo-boo ass shit right here, dude. I tell you that. I wasted 5,000 to get a comment, bro. To get a unlocks ability to track black rocks. Like, what the five thousand fucking points for this? Would have been better off going for this instead. Alright, let's hopefully don't fucking DC whatsoever. Like, my question is, can people have mics or can they even hear me? That's what I'm wondering. You guys have mics? Some of you guys do. No mics. There he is, mics. Lucky heel, mates. Mics? No mics? Yes? No? Like, can we have that as a thing? Really? Green is rare? Honestly, green is rare? Yellow is it? Honestly, I thought it was the other way around. Could have sworn it was the other way around, where green is bad and yellow was fucking amazing. What kind of century am I living in? Man, it's not even... Where's the audio, man? Yeah. Honestly, that last match was fucking horseshit. Only because it fucking lagged his dick off. Alright, let's go, Lampkin Lane. And really? Michael Myers? Why am I always by the exit? I got you, fam. Help me! Did he just quit? Did he quit? Did he legit quit? Did he legit quit? I am fucking confused what the fuck just happened in this match, but I guess he fucking quit. Hey, look at me at the very top of the leaderboards. I don't even know why he quit. Probably because I fucking juked the fuck out of him. Alright, let's get the goodies. Get the fuck out of my face, Gramps. You too. Alright, let me change these fucking controls. Cause the fucking vertical up and down bullshit, dude. It's fucking annoying. Does this make any sense? Why would you give me an option to fucking do this? But I fucking can't. Fuck. Ugh. You're squeezing my balls at this point, game. You know that? You're like gripping tight and like tug of war-ish. Not the good type of tug of war, the bad one. A real, real bad one. What the? You know, I guess I'll stick with the same dirty old pants. I have no idea what the fuck those shit do. I honestly don't. Farm. Let's go again with like round two. Ah, let's see. I'm always by the exit. Hey, what is up? Help me build this or repair this, whatever. Don't fuck up. I swear to God, it's gonna be our funeral. I fucked up! Oh, let's fucking book it! Treasure box. Come on, gimme. Okay, so you're across the other side. That's fine. I'm cool with that. You go do you, boo-boo. Take one for the team! I saw you. Where the fuck did you go? Your ugly ass is still right behind me. She gone? Fucking run, bitch, run! Fucking damn it. still Gucci. At fucking 15. Boy, isn't that great. Go out in a swiggity swoop. All right, you fucking crow. Reunited in a few. Wait, what was that? Go, go, go! No! Get out of here! Need you my totem. Here, my dude, yeah. Don't be afraid, we good, we Gucci, mate. How are you fucking up? Ah! Save him, save him, save him! You piece of potato! He can't hit you! He can't hit you! Don't be afraid! Run away! Oh, he can't hit you, never mind. You have potential, but you let me die! Let me fucking die. Boy, you're right there. Get your sweet baby kiss out of there, boy.
Oh, my bad. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Ah, fuck you!
Guys, it's Scares here, and our first story today comes from Ricegum. Now, if you guys don't know, Ricegum's most recent video has been making quite a bit of hate, and people are asking why. Like, why the hell is Ricegum's video making some hate? And there's a lot of comments saying Dialer Gang, and Dialer Gang is coming after you. And then there's also a lot of comments in Arabic, and everyone's asking, what the heck is this? What's going on? Why is Ricegum getting hate? And why are there all these random people who speak Arabic in his comment section? Well, it turns out that there's a YouTuber known as Dialer, who has over 1.5 million subscribers. He is an Arabic-speaking YouTuber, and this guy actually made a video recently where he actually shows a sneak peek of, like, a diss track against Ricegum. Now, to be honest with you guys, I don't really know much of what he's saying in this video because there's no captions, and it's completely in Arabic, and I don't speak Arabic, and I don't have an Arabic translator on hand. You know, this isn't CNN over here. We don't got translators on deck, so we really don't know what this guy is saying. So if there is any fans that speak Arabic, you definitely should contact me and let me know what this guy is saying. But I'm pretty sure he was going to make, like, a diss track on Ricegum, and he's talking smack to Ricegum and stuff. And a lot of his fans went and hated on Ricegum's video because of his most recent video on him. And for our next story today, we got one here from a Twitch streamer known as Tribate. Now, this guy is a very well-known Twitch streamer. Actually, he's not that well-known. He only has, like, 1,000 followers on Twitch. But while this guy was streaming IRL on Twitch, you know, he was just kind of vlogging like Ice Poseidon does. He was just completely streaming, showing the sidewalk, showing him walking down the street. And a ton of his fans are watching, and they're all, you know, commenting and stuff. And out of nowhere, this one guy just completely straight up robs him.
Hey, top of the morning, beepity boppity. Thank you.
You suck, Kevin.
God, I'm so, so sorry. Oh my God, that made me jump. I've never seen that shit before. Where's that hoodie at? Fuck you. Fuck you, you don't do that. Some bitch can't scoot me. I ain't scared.
awesome, and a lot of people tend to tune into his podcast. Well, during E3's new podcast, he talked about the PewDiePie situation. You guys probably know the situation where PewDiePie said the N-word on his stream, and a lot of people did hate on PewDiePie for this, but there was a lot of people defending PewDiePie as well. Well, it looks like E3 was talking badly about what PewDiePie said in this video, and he was talking badly about PewDiePie in the situation. But there was a lot of fans that noticed, E3, you're kind of a hypocrite for saying some of these things, because E3 straight up said here that PewDiePie was super comfortable with saying the N-word and how he was kind of annoyed with that. And then if you look at his podcast from earlier this year, he straight up says the N-word.
I don't think Felix is a racist person, but god damn, he really kind of just was really comfortable using that word. Nigger, faggot, whore. It's just a wonderful string of words that really gets you going. That really just kind of, fuck you, you faggot. Like, you're reaching for all these words, right? And you're like, oh, let me just, like, a little M-bomb for you. I mean, I know this is...
Ooh. Just right off the bat, mate. Fucking asshole! Thank you very much, friend. I really appreciate your help. Fucking butchering this shit. Fucking A!
to the point a lot of people say, but it certainly seems like that's not the first time he's used that word in that context. And look, if you joke around with your friends privately, we say offensive things privately when we're joking with our friends because we all find it funny for one reason or other. But goddamn, Doug, you're freaking live streaming. I love that. You're saying you're faggot, though.
Yeah.
I feel like you're using a little liberally. I love saying you're a faggot.
Now, to be honest with you guys, YouTubers do this all the time. They end up saying something stupid that the YouTuber read later on. So I'm sure Asia will clear this up in his next podcast. But he did get a ton of hate for this dude. He made over 28,000 dislikes on his most recent podcast. Almost more dislikes than likes on this thing. It's crazy. I've never seen so many people hate on Asia before. So I definitely want to see him clear this up in his next podcast. Definitely no hate to H3H or anything like that. He's a great dude, and I know he'll come back from this, obviously, right? I think he's just going to have to explain it more to some of his fans. And for our next story today, we got one here from KSI and Joe Weller. Now, you guys know KSI and Joe Weller have been going at it for a while. They've actually been a lot of drama. They're apparently supposed to get into a fight in February. They're going to have a boxing match. They've already kind of fought and stuff on stage. And it turns out that KSI has actually been going at Joe Weller on Twitter today. He's been talking a lot of smack to Joe Weller. He just tweeted this out. He said, "Don't blame this one on mental health." And he posted a picture here of Joe Weller in blackface, dude. So obviously he made a bunch of retweets on this, and then Joe Weller responded to KSI with three question marks showing that KSI had like a white face. Now, to be honest with you guys, whiteface isn't even a thing. I don't think that could be considered racist at all. The reason why blackface is considered racist is because of the history with it. But I can see where Joe Weller is coming from here. He's claiming that KSI did the same thing technically. Thank you.
Come on!
Thank you.
I don't know. But KSI responded here saying, my ex did that to me. You actually went out yourself to go and get a makeup team to blacken you up more than once. Joe Weller responded here saying, a professional makeup artist made me look like different football players for a music video you agreed to be part of. How come you say you found it funny then, but are hyping it up now? So to be honest with you guys, that was pretty messed up on KSI's part. I mean, if KSI was cool with it then why, right when they're getting in drama right now, he has to bring it up and act like he's not cool with it? And for an experience, we got one here from a YouTuber known as SmurfinWRX and TJ Hunt. Now, these guys got a lot of drama recently when Smurfin made a video on his channel. He has 300,000 subscribers and claims here that TJ Hunt has just recently pretty much stolen his company. These guys both made this company together, and TJ Hunt is now trying to pretty much take the brand away from him by making a new website with the same branding. It's very strange, and pretty much this Smurfin guy is taking legal action, and they're getting lawyers involved and stuff, and it's gonna be a pretty big deal. If you don't know who TJ Hunt is, he has over 700,000 subscribers, and because of this drama, he's been making a ton of dislikes. So I'd like to see what TJ Hunt has to say about the situation, but as of right now, Smurfin seems to have a pretty good argument here against them. It also looks like the YouTuber Colossal is crazy, or as people like to call him, Clown, ended up getting suspended over Twitter. He had a ton of followers on Twitter. He got his entire account suspended. People were asking why. I think it's because he might have posted an old tweet that someone decided to just, I guess, take out of context and maybe try to take down his Twitter account with, which really sucks. I hope that that's not the case. And that's it for our video today, guys.
I just quit?